Star Family Farm. I'm Christy.
I'm me.
Alright. And we're in a collaboration with Wholesome Roots, Rose and Ryan, about the good, the bad, and the ugly of homesteading, right? You got this covered?
This is the good. This section
is the bad.
And this section's the ugly.
How do you figure?
Ugly. Bad.
Why good. Is this the bad?
Well, this is where processing happens.
And this is the good?
Dispersal.
That's
the intake.
He's just sitting here. What's the matter, Wilbur? I don't want that in. But I don't think that's what Rose had in mind.
Well, let's try our other model.
No, let's not try our other model.
Oh, I lost your other model.
Carl!
Carl ran off. He's like, you're not doing that to me.
Anyway, Carl's underneath.
So, okay. Son, get up here.
Here's Carl. I found Carl books.
Okay.
This is the good. This is the bad. That's so good.
He's got schmutz on this side. Get away from me. No, come on. Get his butt out of my face. They're cute, but no, that's not what Rose had in mind. Come on, we have to do a whole video on this.
How long does the video have to be?
She didn't say, but I know she doesn't want to see the puppies and go good, bad, and the ugly. I don't think that's what they
want. I'll get my reading glasses off.
So, oh, I didn't even realize I had mine on. I could take them off.
Okay.
All right, so the good of homesteading. Number one. And no, we don't have a list. We're just going to count them off to sound like we do.
You get to make up whatever hours you like. You can stay up late. Get up early. You can sleep in.
But not all homesteaders have a stay-at-home job. Some have to go and actually have a regular day job. So then they would have to get up.
Unless they call in sick.
So, let's go back to the good, because that's not really cutting it, is it? Alright, the good of homesteading. Number one, you can control and regulate your food. Whether it be raising your own meat, right? You can control what goes in it. What are you doing?
I'm becoming a popsicle.
You're becoming a popsicle?
Yeah, do it.
Son, you're a goofball.
So I'm a popsicle.
Okay, back on track. You're off. You got me off track now. Okay, so you're a popsicle. You're a dork. You can regulate your food, right? You can grow basically what your family likes, what you want, right? You'll have good nutrition. You don't have to pay high prices of organic and all that stuff, right? Because
if organic food?
If you do it yourself, then it is organic, or at least you know what's on it, right?
Ah, dishwash. Who needs organic anyways?
So, the good is that you know what's going into your food. You can grow your own food. The peace and quiet, unless you have an RJ. Well, and not all people homestead in the peace and quiet, do they? Some people homestead
never.
On the balcony.
Ever.
Carl. Nope. Who is it?
Wilbur.
I don't know. Somebody's after my plug-in.
Wilbur. We're tag-teaming it. One's over there. One's over here. One's over there.
Okay. Back to the good.
Okay.
You can stockpile food. If you get a good crop of one thing, you can always can it and preserve it and, right, dehydrate it, all that kind of stuff, right?
I can see up my nose with this mirror.
Okay, not on task, not on topic. Okay, so that's the good of homesteading, right, is you
the bad.
Control
I
your
know the
food.
Bad.
Okay, what's the bad?
You get so sick of whatever crop comes in good, you will literally want to starve before you eat it again.
Or you get attached to the animal you're supposed to be eating, and you cry when you eat it.
Never had that problem. Mom always picked the main ones to eat.
Except for bacon.
Oh yeah, bacon was good. I like bacon.
We didn't cry when we ate him, though. I cried when I dropped him off. But I didn't cry when I ate him. So, the bad would be...
Having to expense, having to clean stalls. When it's 105 and you're going...
Yeah, and your garden burns up pretty much, you know.
Or when it's -5 outside and you're still in the barn cleaning stalls.
Chores.
And you're going,
So the weather would be a big part of the bad because it can go either way.
Because every time...
And it's not perfect every day, is it, Sam?
It's probably 1 in 5 times is it actually decent.
And those 1 in 5 times are spread out, aren't they? It's called spring and fall.
1 in 10 times. 1 in 10.
Okay. So, pretty much the bad is losing crops, losing animals. Let's go on to the ugly, because our ugly of homesteading is a lot uglier than what people think, huh?
Pour another round of whatever. What's this one do?
Let's see. Okay, come on. Our ugly is pretty ugly, and we've seen some really ugly things, correct? Alright, let's just start. The ugliest thing is when a farm fails and people refuse to let go. How many times have we heard, I can't sell them at the sale because they won't bring what they're worth, but we see animals out starving in a field?
Bunch.
Okay. Knowing when to quit and when to let go is the ugly. We had a family or a homestead. They were going to grow enough to feed the animals. And what happened when winter came, RJ?
They didn't have enough.
They didn't. And they wouldn't sell the animals because they wouldn't bring enough at the sale. Well, if you'd have sold them back when they were healthy, they would have brought enough, and it could have helped you get the winter. What are some of the other things that we've seen? Horses living on a loaf of bread a week. Right? It's not enough. And the ugly is, if you don't have enough for those animals, you have to get rid of them. Will they bring what you're wanting at sale, or how much you think they're worth? No. But that's what keeps us in business. It's a very sad fact, but it is what keeps us in business, because when those are confiscated by the police or the Department of Agriculture, where do they go, RJ?
The Straw Family Farm. The guy with amazing hair. Look at this. Look at this hair. Look at this hair.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I don't even know where this fits in, but what about not being able to find a shearer and not knowing how to shear it yourself, so it's out there in the summer having 100 degree heat stroke? That'd be the ugly, huh? And the truth is, that sheep, if you can't find a shearer, or you don't know how to shear, I suggest you learn. Because that animal wearing a wool coat in 100 degree weather, 110, 107, plus humidity,
they're not all like Shrek.
No. They're not going to make it. Shrek, the one that was done, was overseas, so he didn't see 100 degree weather. That's what people fail to see, is they look at these sheep that have been let go for 7 or 8 years. They don't live here in Oklahoma, people. They don't live in Florida. They don't live in Arizona. They don't live in California. They don't live in the South. They don't live where there's humidity. That's right. Shrek survived in caves in either Ireland or Scotland or something over in Europe. In the mountains. Where it was cold. To them, a 70 degree day is cold, is hot. Here, 110, we're going, yeah, I think I might have to turn on the air conditioner. It's a big difference. So the ugly is the brutal truth of when you fail, it can get ugly. RJ, how many times have we heard that there's a learning curve?
Look, guys, I'm juggling. Okay.
How many times have we heard there's a learning curve?
Bunch.
What does that mean to us?
That things aren't going well.
Yep. Every animal is a living, breathing life. And if you're telling me there's a learning curve, how much of a learning curve did you have when you had children? That's how much learning curve you should have when you take on sheep, goats,
alpacas, puppies.
Puppies that are growling. There should not be a learning curve. You should have a vet. You should know how to take care of the animal. If something arises, you need to have money in the bank to take care of those vet bills. We did a series not too long ago, maybe a year ago, about the men of mom's life. The men of mom's life. Who are the men of mom's life? It's not you, is it?
For sure. vet. And a horse trainer.
If you don't have a good vet, I know we don't talk a lot about him, but RJ, you were just on the phone with his office today, weren't you?
Yep.
And we were on the phone last week with him, correct? Mm-hmm. We talk to our vet probably once a week, at least.
Enough to say he stays on my frequent caller list.
Yeah. So if you're not prepared for those bills, if you're not in a relationship with your vet, you need to get there. And that takes money. And if you don't have that money, you don't need to have animals. It's that simple. Things cost money. And to say, oh, well, there's a learning curve. My question to you is, if you think there's a learning, if you think there's a learning curve, how many curves are there going to be that cost life? Okay?
Crash, come
on. And are you going to have to put your family before those lives? Unless you have a huge garden and can put up enough for the sheep and the goats and all that. Now, are they, when they put them up, can they can everything for a sheep or goat?
No.
Can you grow enough raw?
No.
Not in our climate. Now, you might be able to
grow it up. You have a big garden, you might be able to.
Yeah, but will it last all winter?
You have to have a really big garden. Like, if you have an acre garden or so, you could probably do it.
If you have a growing season that will continually grow something, correct?
I mean, like, if they would grow like an acre of corn and then put it up in a silo, then it would.
That's true. You could do that. It's possible.
But that's a lot of corn, dude.
That's a lot of corn. But then, you've got to balance it, correct? You can't just feed them corn all year long.
Oh, yes, she's
especially goats. You got to get some oats. Some soybean meal.
Maybe some soybeans, some wheat. Yeah, you need to get you some variety.
So you'd have to have at least an acre of each of those, correct?
Yeah, but your wheat you can grow after you put your corn in. Yeah. After you pull your corn out, so it grows in the wintertime. So.
Wait. Are we homesteading or farming?
I don't know. I'm just saying, I mean, you have to be a part farmer.
There you go. You'd have to be part farmer. But what we're saying is that ugly is pretty much Barnyard Animal Planet Cops version, correct? Okay, that's reflecting. But we've seen some really bad stuff, correct?
I am in the spotlight.
And if you can't afford food, water, shelter. Food, water, and shelter. How many times have we seen just barbed wire put around a pasture and horses in there? No gate. No way to get hay in there. No way to get food in there. Was there any water in there? No.
They drank out of the ditch.
And in Oklahoma, there's drought conditions right now, so they're not drinking out of anything. Hey, Miss Piggy, you're interrupting. So, the ugly can get really ugly. Our word to you is know your limits. Know when it's time to say, I can't do this. Be grown up enough to say, I have to sell. Will you get what they're worth? Maybe, maybe not. It doesn't matter. They'll be alive. So the ugly on our end is a lot of what we deal with. And the ugly is really ugly. I thought about actually popping some pictures in there. Some things that were taken in and I chose not to. You also have to be prepared for things that aren't your problem, aren't your issue, right, son?
Right.
What about the homesteader that had sheep get attacked by dogs?
Yeah, you had to surround it.
She had everything planned. She lived on the outskirts of town. A pack of dogs came and chewed up some of her sheep. And when I say chewed up, it was pretty bad, huh? Okay, then she couldn't afford the vet bills and she couldn't keep the dogs out. So, that's pretty bad, correct?
Mm-hmm.
So, it's not that she didn't have the money for the feed. It's not that she was doing anything wrong. She couldn't control her environment. And if you're too close to home, the ugly can get really ugly with other animals. So, that's something else to take into consideration, correct? Okay, anything else? Anything for the good?
I can't remember anything.
The bad?
I can't remember anything.
the ugly.
I kind of forgot about this video, so we're kind of winging it.
Yep, we don't have a script. It's just us being us. So.
Well, and I dialed like all the way up, so I keep being told, dial it down, dial it down. So.
He's slow. He's sleepy. And yeah, we're doing hay. We're making this video in the middle of hay season, huh?
Yep.
How many bales you put up yesterday?
250 total. Okay. 150 yesterday and 100 today.
So. Alright. Well, we're going to get off of here. You guys, just remember to do it slow so that the ugly doesn't take over. The good is great. The bad, you can tolerate. The ugly, you don't want anything to do with. So it normally leads to criminal charges, doesn't it?
So. Sometimes.
All right.
It's hair, it is great, though. I need a haircut, though. Because I get too flashy, you know? I'm going to have to cut a bunch of hair up here and now.
I didn't say, what's with the mustache?
We've been haying, and I haven't felt
that shame. That's the ugly. All right, guys, we're
off.
All
right, guys,
we've
got to get off here before the camera breaks.
Yes, we got to
it's looking at me
get
going,
this rose, and we will talk at y'all later.
Peace out, Girl Scout.
Bye.